guys, it's the History Nerd, and we're back with another episode of Civ 5, Brave New World, Venice. Let's go ahead and hit next turn and see what the world has to offer. Apparently, a public decoration looks like that. Let's see. Okay, so... I want to try and remember what it is I'm doing. Oh, get over it,
Bird.
Yes, we can work together. Yeah. So that's the trick, isn't it? If I want to restore the Carthaginian cities, which is what I definitely want to do, I gotta get my freaking army all the way over here. Is annoying, although now that Carthage is sort of cut off, hopefully the Carthaginians can take it themselves, although I don't know if they're even at war and really do that. Who knows? I certainly don't. Yay. Like we're waiting for those guys to heal. I don't think they can heal in foreign territory. So it's going to be a long save. Well, I guess not that long of a save. That's not bad. That's not bad at all. Send it back to Texcoco there. And I should have been looking at what I'm doing. Fortunately, it seems like I'm not able to hold down the right mouse button. There we go. Now I can see what's happening. So, yeah, because of all of those stupid movements, in particular moving that guy out there, you're kind of stuck. Alright. Next. I'll figure it out one day.
Det er en fin aftale. Selv en simpel tigger ville være enig.
No. I'm sure it's disappointing. You wanted a grand and I did not give it to you. The Bank of Venice isn't open for free taking of my money. You want to trade me something, anything, anything for it. We can trade. I'm okay doing that. Hey. Alright. Yeah, just a little alert. Both of you guys, stay there. And then we can push on to the next city. Which, unfortunately, yeah, I guess we could leave him in Mecca, couldn't we? Holy city for Islam. But we've got the holy city for, yeah, for Confucius. Yes, we do. So what I could wind up doing is liberating the Carthaginians completely, and then just giving back Theowilcan and Tlatelolco there to to the people I'm at war with, these guys.
بكل ربي وفي قلم ثنا شوي لخ بقرب تقابلي ايه
cool. That's my price. You don't want to pay it, it's fine. You obviously don't need to get through Venetian territory. You know.
genuine work of art has as much reason for being as the earth and the sun.
Huzzah! More tourism. Little Venice. Perfect. Create a great work, please. Alright, now, in the comments, Blowfly suggested that I give historical information about the great people who pop up, which I think is a great idea. And if I knew anything, I could give factual information. But since I don't, Caspar David Friedrich is obviously an artist, seen showing his work here, The Wanderer Above the Sea of Fog, which was his first self-portrait. He did it from behind because he cannot paint faces. And Friedrich here was a notorious artist from Romantic period, from Dusseldorf. So there you have it. Caspar David Friedrich, a great artist, horrible at faces, and here he is looking out into the sea. And fog. So there you go. Don't take any of that as truth. Please, please. This is all bullshit. Because I don't know anything about most of these people. So if I can give you factual information, I will. Otherwise, please disregard anything and everything I have to say. Cool? Let's see. Oh, my. Yes, we have got tons of places. So that's probably, we've got four. So what I'm thinking we can do is a great work of art from each period. And that'll probably be a thing for the museum. I can't really see. I can't really see. But, like, here, obviously, the Chapel of Renaissance Venetian Art. That's easy. But I can't see what combinations I can slap together to, to put in there. No theming bonus. I don't know. I can figure that out sometime, I guess. Maybe. Who knows? Let's see, what are we... Whoa. That was dumb. Ah, crap. Okay. Sometimes, you know, I don't think my things... Fine. Then I can send this guy over here to rescue that worker. And I've got an archaeologist going there, which is good because we've got plenty of more artifacts to get out of the ground. Oh, come along, you're fine. Prepare! How's my man's doing? Still healing up, guys? Doing okay? Ready to push on to the next city? I hope. And yeah, what we're gonna do, just completely leave Mecca alone. Just ignore it. Get Hippo Regius and Utica there, and Carthage, if we can. Back to the Carthaginians. And then we can just get the other Aztec cities back from the Aztecs. Because I'm not wanting to fully expect. Where are you going? I keep running. And you're ready. Okay. So we'll just put you there for now. We've got some more positioning to do. In the water. Prepare both those guys up. Oh, hello. You shouldn't be here, should you? No, no, you shouldn't. I don't even know if I want to keep Tex Kogo to be. Oh, no, it's got silk. I definitely want to keep Tex Kogo. Actually, I should do a little tour of the resources here. Ooh, iron, silver. Maybe I will keep this land. Yeah. Screw the Aztecs. They can stick with Mecca. Now here's a concerning thing that I just happened to notice. We only have 2 out of 10 possible trade routes going. We're making quite a lot of money considering we're not trading with anybody. So perhaps I should expand my trade routes a little bit. No. How dare you? First off, you don't need the assist.
Anuk chashav diber wa yadati. Tisufa lata.
And I'm guessing you don't have the gold to spare, do you? So you're going to give me all your money and horses? That doesn't tell you what. Tell you what. Here you go. I'm not going to give you money. I'm going to give you some food. And protection. Just leaving a settler there to get hunted? Not that I'm complaining. But if that's your plan. Killing civilians. What I do. So considering the Tekla, although I guess I don't know where they are, I'm going to have to send him up there. And Yun, English, use it. You're done! Sometimes I blame the weather. It's. Yeah, sure.
What?
Sounds great. Actually, your research agreement does sound great. I should lock that. It's the first snowfall. The first major snowfall of the season. And absolutely shut the city down yesterday. Right. And we're not just talking about, like, a little snowfall. Like, it was, you know, hoodie weather. Or out. Not everybody wears a hoodie, no one knows what it is. It's a hooded sweatshirt. So it was hooded sweatshirt weather. And that was Sunday. And then over the course between Sunday night and Monday morning. That's just crumbling, isn't it? That's not good. The temperature dropped about 30 degrees. The wind chill dropped it about another 10. And, yeah. Then we got, I think the final count was in the 20 centimeter-ish range of snowfall. So it's been a very sad reintroduction to winter this year. It certainly came in harsh. But typical Canadian fashion, by today, we had most of the main roads cleared, and people are wearing their furry hats and gloves and big puffy jackets, so we'll survive. I mean, I'll be honest, too, we've been quite lucky this year. That's right, guys. This is what this has come to. I'm talking about the weather. But we have been pretty lucky, because it's December and it hasn't snowed really all that much. Why? You need to stop that because the Aztecs are taking notice and they are watching for us. Let's see. So that's the city we're going to want to hit. So 1-2, I'm going to want a cannon to go there. I should have left another freaking road. Not much can be done about that now. We'll suffer through it. Friendly soldiers there, we can return that, can't we? Maybe? At least we'll be able to recover those soldiers when needed. You are in the city, correct? Yes. Okay. You can't see anything, so you can just go on alert. Come on. Let's get to my turn. Not from Beds of Congo. Oh, I know. Barbarian Archer Reserve. Alright. Well, this is apparently not a good place to be healing. But we can send a worker up there to repair. And yeah, we'll just leave it there. I see what you're up to. I think I don't know. You guys in position? Little addition to the Venetian Empire. Kind of wish I went after these guys, oh, I don't know, 500 years ago. Oh well. My other concern is, oh no, because puppets don't increase that. Aztec City, I want to leave the Aztecs. That's the problem I'm having right now. Let's stay closer. Now, we have barbarians to hunt. You've got a lot of resources in Mecca are really good. That's why I'm kind of leaning towards thinking. What? It's taken you a while to figure out what you're doing. No! Pillage! Yes! Haha! Okay. And so you pillage, so now you can heal. But I haven't. Doing smart something like this. So now you can just should be able to hit those guys. Ah, perfect. But the thing is, I don't want to actually wipe the Aztecs out. That is not at all what I want to do. So am I gonna have enough for all this crap? I guess they are just books. Yeah, I'll have time to get the ball again. Make things happy. Right?
Yes.
Next turn. You've shifted your focus to a different group of soldiers, have you? Very well. I'll play that game. Can't imagine their happiness is not that great, so. Oh, good, I'm merchant. Yeah, he's gone, so you can just go. What have we there? We're definitely going to want to consider buying a city-state here. I see you, Siamese nurse, or missionary. You're not a mercenary. What would be a good city-state to purchase, though? Maybe someone over here. There's a nice antiquity site there, which would be nice to secure. Or should I go back over and maybe purchase Mbanza Kongo there? Because Monaco's been a good ally, and we will keep them as a good ally. That certainly is a possibility. Or maybe Kiev. Because really, Kiev's not helping much. Question is, well, they've got pearls. Pearls is good. Pearls aren't good. Or maybe over on the other side of the world. Yes, we are going to purchase Prague. They've got iron, which is useful. They've got an antiquity site, which I'll definitely want to get a hold of before Sydney gets it. Or maybe Sydney would be the one to go after then. Well, that doesn't really matter. I can just send people there. Would furs be good? I don't think I'm producing. Oh no, I'm producing a lot of furs, aren't I? Well, not a lot, but. I have no furs. Alright. Sure, this is thrilling watching. I think we'll actually go with Sydney then. They've got some fish, they've got furs. What's in Bucharest? Fish and furs, so it's the same, but Sydney is going to be further south, which means it's warmer, and warmer is always better. No question about that. So I don't know if it's alright, we'll give you some cover defenses. What are you sitting on? Just a normal mine? Should be able to snag this. We'll just pillage. And here. And repair that farm. And then we can't pillage, so we'll just attack. Perfect. Create a puppet. And I think that might have changed. I'm not really, I think that went up, but not by a lot. Still, it might not be a bad idea to not take Mecca, despite it being a much better city than Tlatelo Loco, whatever. Repair. Repair the banana plantation. About to call that a banana. Certainly not even a thing. My city becomes
Wales. Contano Michael Schnoo.
Wales, okay, yeah, Wales for salt. Now we can both enjoy salted whale. But there's kind of a point, Montezuma. And this is what you're failing to realize. Is that all I really... Okay. From this point, I might be able to negotiate something where I get Carthage, Utica, and Hippo Regius, and then I can just gift those back to Carthage.
Plenum Tikneki!
Yeah, I bet.
Oh, Tiki.
Why are they booing me? I gave them a perfectly reasonable deal that they chose to disregard and are forcing this war to continue. If they would simply give up the land that isn't theirs, this wouldn't be a problem. Right? Rationality and geopolitics. Gosh darn it. Let's get you. Get some sort of ranged defense for that city, although I don't think the Aztecs have much left. They're pretty gone. Florence is religious, which means it's not my religion, unfortunately. They're Buddhists. But only half Buddhists, so. Don't have anything to do. Great building wise, it would require a great engineer, so I don't really need to worry about that, but it is nice to know that I can purchase them with faith. That's exciting.
A good night.
Oh, and we get a new policy too? Well, that's good. Yeah. And we'll worry about getting that eventually. One of these days. Okay. Technology tree. And I would assume that rifling would be a good thing to go for. However, perhaps scientific theory would be good instead. Get some schools built up. Big Ben, that'll help. Yeah, we'll go with industrializing. Oh, that's good. Scientific theory takes no time at all. And that's kind of cool. That's like, I must have been already researching that. Yeah. Okay, well, we'll finish up the research in that. Doing good things in Phoenicians. Like, making money, I guess. And just hold it there for the rest of my units to repair themselves. My, that lake is annoying. I wish I could get my fleet in there. As it is now, it's sitting here kind of useless. But... shall just leave them as they are. And I think we'll want to put... actually, leaving you there is not a bad idea. Yes. I just want to get the archaeologist to this camp so we can start building a dam. Went up there, then we can start doing some more buildings in Venice. We'll slowly continue. Oh, Sydney. What did you do when it's coming? Well. I dare say that our wealth is certainly helping with some things. undeveloped regions. Iron. Oh, hello. All right. Next turn. Wish there was a way to raid caravans. I mean, there must be. There's a way to raid sea caravans, so there's got to be to raid land caravans. I was about to call them non-sea caravans, and that would be sick. Not concerned about getting pelted by crossbow bolts, or indeed, old-school Stone Age arrows. It's just not intimidating. So if we move you there and are just like, hello, caravan, you're not coming through.
So what do you...
Yeah, sure, we'll keep that going. Oh, good, yes. Well, we managed to end that caravan and gain 100 gold. Yes, we are all great friends who don't like Persia because of what Persia's doing to your continent. Almost ready to go. We've got one more turn. Nice unit promotion, considering where we're fighting. We're getting a rough terrain bonus. And we're going to slaughtering them. That's important. Now, let's see. We've got a worker over there working on that.
สวัสดีเราเชื่อว่านี่เป็นข้อเสนอที่ยุติธรรมสำหรับทั้งสองฝ่ายท่านคิดว่าอย่างไร
So here's the neat thing. How about instead of worrying about horses and a lump sum payment of gold, just provide me some gems? Oh wow, that worked quite well, didn't it? Perhaps we should look at continuing the trade of luxury resource for luxury resource in the future. No, how dare you? We just traded gems for things. Not about to attack him. He's got gems. And now the war of attrition begins, and indeed the retreat from those, you know, less developed people who still fling sticks at us. Uncivilized. Now, attacking Hippo Regius here is going to be a bit of a challenge. But with that damn river. So, we're going to shift some units to the north, but again, because it's right along, I would imagine, the coastline here. Perhaps not, but it looks like it is. I guess this is why we should be using scouting units. Because scouting units shows us... Now, my good city of Venice. That's a great place for the artillery. Did we capture? Oh, that's destroyed. That's too bad. I would have liked to have captured that great person. I would have added quite a lot, I think, to Venice. Range, so just wait. Who can we attack? Oh, hello. Yes. Sorry, I don't necessarily enjoy slaughtering civilians, but the First Council of Persophilus. What have we got? Science funding. Well, that does sound good. But the repeal of the trade against city-states is really what I'm looking for. So how can I... I can't do anything, can I? Okay. I guess we're still 5 turns out from voting. Yes. Right. Why bother to give me a pop-up to say, hey, 5 turns, I'm going to give you a pop-up. But I digress. It is what it is. I should be expanding my trade, because it can definitely happen. Hurry up, great merchant, make it along, would you? Ignoring the barbarian camps, they won't hurt you. Really? Seems dated. Identify people stealing archaeology. Monaco, that's good. Buenos Aires. Slowly coming up there, aren't you? Slowly. We'll get you one day, my friend. Actually, we can just do this. Hey, how about a gift? You want $1,000? Winner is you. Nope. Poor maneuvering. Oh, that's quick to get there, isn't it? I guess we're not following. Alright. Well, that'll do for now. Repaired that yet? Come on. We haven't got all day. It's almost the 20th century. A Reformation belief. Oh, such a young religion.
Great advantage.
All right, I guess we'll go with industrialization now. Although finding out where oil is important, so is finding coal, and so is getting our industry up to snuff. And you can repair the wood choppy place. We definitely need those. Can we start shelling this stupid city now? So you can go there. You can go there. You can come down there. Doing that is not what I want to do just yet. Instead, I would like to try and allow my infantry to survive a bit longer. Thankfully, because they have no military units there, it shouldn't be that much of a concern. Although those guys are definitely going to wind up dead, aren't they? I'm going to have to pull them out. Still probably within range of the stupid city. Let's shoot out a bit here. We'll go heal instantly. Burn you and fortify, and just shell you again. Cargo ship, where can we trade? Nowhere from here. Okay, back. We're going to change your home city to... Actually, if we go to Florence... That'll be a much safer trade route to China, that's for sure. Okay. And, yeah. All of these guys stay on alert. Finished our cargo ship, which is a bit of a waste, so we'll go with the public school now. Persia is a close second, and China's a relatively close third, and then everybody else is a distant, doesn't really matter. Okay. Oh, good. We should be, I mean, we should see these going up. Well, falling with Siam, I don't like that, but everywhere else it looks... Well, just fine with me. Great writer, creating great work. Jules Verne, now I do know this.
Captain Nemo pointed at this prodigious heap of shellfish, and I saw that these mines were genuinely inexhaustible, since nature's creative powers are greater than man's destructive instincts.
Who was a science fiction writer? And he wrote things like 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea. I think he wrote a book about going to the moon. And Time Travel 2, I believe. Or I know Jules Verne from Back to the Future, and that could be the time travel reference. I'm not sure which is which, but... Trade with Persia, really? Do I have to trade with them? Why can't I trade with Shanghai? I guess I'm already trading with Shanghai. Alright, so when we get Sydney, that'll be a better base for Siamese trading, won't it? And trade with Denmark as well. Okay. Mainly because, in this game, Persia just thinks they're hot potatoes and are basically trying to get them. Which, I guess that's what you do in a Civ game, but you know what? I'm in second place, so... That's that. So we have discovered plundered ancient ruins of Beads, plundered by Venice. Yay, we're plunderers. We could create a landmark, which is useless. Our borders will never reach there, and perhaps Mongolia's will, so that is Mongolia, right? Right? Or, yeah, the Huns. So we'll just create a new chart. And now it's a bare mountain. There were a lot of beads there, so much so that from a distance, oh, that is cool. It looks like it's kind of showing off the things they're digging up there. How many turns have we got left? We got a few turns left on that. Okay, so we'll get to the Persepolis. Okay, I should have done this. Damn my idiocy. Okay, yeah, open borders are fine, but I want you to vote yay. Right? This leader will use its core delegation of two delegates to support yay on the proposal to repeal these. Yes, propose. Perfect. Look, here's the thing. Add Carthage. Then it's, you're gonna lose your cities. This is how it's got to work. I'm not gonna make peace with you while Carthage is still under your hands and not back in the Carthaginian hands. Ignoring the hypocrisy of me owning a bunch of these cities, it's just not right, damn it. Alright. Balls. Why am I getting the freaking defensive runaround from a stupid... Oh. Crossbowman is dead. Oh dear. Hello, rifleman. You're far more than I have. Close this. start going on a diplomatic hunt. Okay, so we got China in our
Indeed, good places. Indeed, Don Rob. Rao, come along, fang you.
I can't. Oh, so China's spying on me.
A liar, Kichiotish. Chopla.
Montezuma won't do a thing. Denmark.
He'll die. Let's.
Darius, yeah, he died of me.
Dumb. The belt.
Got our two votes there. I thought I had four, but I guess that's the next session. Commit those delegates to repeal that. Yes, please. We'll see if we're victorious. That all you got? That ain't no thing. Frogs in awe of me, of course. You're allied with Persia. So, what? Who doesn't want to trade with city-states? Who's an idiot? Siam? And even China didn't go along with it. They're like, yeah, well, okay, yeah, we'll vote the way you want. No. Man, nobody wants science funding. Nobody wants... No! Why? Why can't there be an undo button? Why can't there be an undo button? Why can't they just be like, what? I made a mistake. It happens. No new land was revealed. You didn't learn any super secret movements of any empires. You can go back. Okay. Well, now that I'm thoroughly demoralized, and Persia's being a freaking dick with their world conquest crap. It seems like a good place to leave the video there. So, thumbs up if you've enjoyed this. Leave your comments, questions, concerns, thoughts, jokes, musings, what have you below. Thank you all very much for watching, and we'll see you next time.